The study with an acronym SCALAF trial, which was conducted in Zwolle, Netherlands, and presented by Arif Elvan. This is the first randomized trial, surgical versus catheter ablation, standalone surgical ablation in paroxysmal or early persistent atrial fibrillation using a bipolar Medtronic device. And the main strength of the study is that it used implantable loop recorder to detect any episode of atrial fibrillation. The main result of the trial is that the standalone ablation, surgical ablation, is worse than catheter ablation. The freedom from arrhythmias after 2 years without antiarrhythmic drugs was 56% in catheter group versus 30% in surgical group. That's a surprising result for many of us. And also the burden of atrial fibrillation below 0.5, which is a very small burden, was significantly lower at 2 years in the catheter group versus surgical group. And that also emphasizes the need for using beat-to-beat analysis of the data, because especially after surgical ablation, you may not feel atrial fibrillation because there is some kind of denervation. What is worrying in the trial is the complication rate was tripled in the surgical group versus catheter group. And especially major complications were significantly higher in the surgical group. That was 22% versus zero in ablation group, in catheter ablation group. So this is worrying because other trials with even with long-term persistent atrial fibrillation reported a much lower complication rate after surgical ablation. So we need explanation for this. In conclusion, the study clearly showed that we cannot recommend standalone surgical ablation for patients with paroxysmal or early persistent atrial fibrillation. This study may change guidelines, because in recent guidelines on catheter and surgical ablation of atrial fibrillation, surgical standalone ablation was recommended as to be indication, so it may shift to 3 class. And then I think the main research would be anyway in long-term persistent, because that's the major indication for me for surgery, for standalone surgery. I think today we can do catheter ablation in paroxysmal atrial fibrillation with many tools like cryo or laser balloon or contact force catheters very quickly. It can be within 2 hours, everything done with very high margin for safety. So I think that's a future. We'll be right back.